Some people, they insist not to be happy. It's okay. We don't want unhappy people around us, right? I don't want that sickness to appear to me. I want to be happy every day, even if I am sick. It's okay. If you are not happy with Allah, Allah is not happy with you. Allah is asking to His angels now. Time is changing. Angels, they just move up from here. New ones came down. The other ones witness everything. Saying to them, what is my servants they are doing now? Oh, Ya Rabbi, saying angels, you have this many billion on the face of earth. They all heedlessly sleeping, sad, because since last night they were doing so many wrong things that you have forbid to them, and they are not up now. So they are not up to receive what I'm sending to them. New day, new rewards. Okay. That many rewards is coming down. How many people on the face of earth? No one was up. Some group of people up, running for this dunya. Good. If they are getting up early to run for this dunya, give this much reward to those. Even if they're not getting up for me, but they are active. They living like human. They getting up morning. Good. You hear the birds outside? Do you hear the birds?
Yes, sir.
They never miss it. This time they start. Right away, they're all ready. They are very happy with Allah, dancing, singing. The humans that created in our Seni Takvim. I want to look at their face, so many of them. Angels, they run away from them. I cannot look at this one. Talking about Muslims, I'm not talking about non-Muslims. They're saying, well, what? That's good, I like it, you see. Number one.
MashaAllah.
Well, Hasul is asking. Yeah. Some people, they get up. But they get up and they are praying, but they are so sad. They are not happy with you. They are so sad. Because you put this to them and they are so upset, they're getting up by force. Make their whole day long more set. All that they are praying is okay. Make their day all day long to be more set. And saying some, they just get up so happy with you. They have so much problems, but they say, oh, you are the only one what it matters. You don't care whatever happens. So those ones, that whatever I'm sending down and the other ones they're not up to take, share it to those ones. Everyone running, waiting for Mehdi, alayhi salam. What do you think you're going to get on the time of Mehdi? You're not going to get this much reward in the time of Mehdi. Because time of Mehdi, everyone is going to be ready to receive everything. Nobody's going to leave anything to anybody. But now, look at your neighborhood. Where do you live? Calculate and understand how many people are up early in the morning. Holy Prophet saying, everything has their own king. The prayers, they have their own king. And the king's all the prayers is Fajr prayer. that if you treat Fajr prayer properly all day long, you'll be okay. Even that day, difficult test Allah prepare for you, He will send ease to you to be able to carry it. Otherwise, you'll be suffering. Why you are suffering? Why you have problems? Eh? Because of Akhirat? You have problems because you're worrying for Akhirat? You have problems because you're worrying, you are sad that you are not making progress in the way of Allah? That's the problem you have? No, you don't have that problem. Dunya problem you have. But all the rizqs now is sending down to people to be sharing. You see, what Allah is sending, saying, those who get up, even if they didn't get up for my sake, and they get up running after this dunya, give that rizq to them that I sent to them. Give that blessing to them, because they are active. They are moving. They are not dead. It's okay. I like my servants to be happy with me. Then later, they have so much problem, they're thinking, oh, my heart is a little bit different. Maybe I have a heart problem. Let me go to doctor. They go to a doctor, they say, you have a problem. We gotta keep you inside the hospital for a couple of days. What I'm gonna do now? I even work, I don't have money. I'm gonna pay the bill, but get more sick. Wake up to yourselves, wake up. Say, Bilal, how many times you went to the barn, everyone who goes to the barn, to those animals, how many times any one of you went to the barn, either to the sheep, or to the cows, or to the horse, or to the chickens, or and they are sleeping this time?
Never sure.
How they are early in the morning? See how they are? Just like those birds. They're waiting, they cannot wait at the door. I used to have this idiot sleeping. The animals are screaming from there. Open the door! And that one is sleeping. I have to go to wake him up. At least he learned now. Your life, it will change. You have to make the move. You don't make the move, nothing changes. Think on it a little bit. According to that. Otherwise, whatever is writing for you today, that's what you're gonna get anyway. So that's the worry. If you're ready, so many things will be writing for you. You don't run away that time, you run away from the other time. You'll be fed up with this dream. At that time, you don't know how to enjoy the life, what's coming. Don't be sad always. Don't be sad. Sad people is not entering the paradise. First, you have to be happy, then entering the paradise. Otherwise, sadness is not entering the paradise. You don't get rid of the sadness, maybe smiling. I never saw him sad. Yes, so much world, the problems, that kind of thing. You think I don't know? Yes, maybe more problems than anybody else here, worldly. MashaAllah. What did you ask me one time? What did you ask? You remember what? What?
Sheikh, is it okay to smile in the prayer?
Ha 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 ha. Yes. It's okay. But if you are like him, it's okay. Don't make believe. Don't say that Hashem said so that we just smile and laugh with the prayer. No. If you are like him, submit it, it's okay, it's accepted. Not like this Bengali here. It's forbidden to it. He only smiles when he hears about money. When he hears that money is gonna come. New business came. That time he's very happy. He's running top speed. If you see him in this street, he doesn't even talk to you that time. I'm not joking. Let him say. Oh, I gotta go, I'm very busy now. He wears nice suit and tie too. High heel shoes because he wants to talk.
Can I keep money in my
pants? Huh? Yeah, you can calculate them too. Whatever you are busy with, that's what you're going to bring to the prayer to anyway. That's all. That's what people there are doing. Whatever they are busy with, they bring that to the prayer. Whatever you love, that's what you're busy with. Story of Isa alayhi salam with the donkey, remembers, as it said too many times. Only two of you remember, three. So far, another. Yeah, remember it? You remember. Tell the story, I want to hear too. Mesut, that's what Prophet used to say to him, Mesut saying, read from the Quran. And saying, Ya Rasulallah, the Quran came to you, said, I like to hear from others too. Crazy Googles in the world, all right? I'm not joking. Go put some crazy Googles on him over there.
After Hazrat Isa Islam was lifted from this world, he was going to spread the message to one group of people in an area, and they said to him that they wanted him, they said to him, if you're a follower of Isa Islam, then you should be able to do the same things that he did. So why don't you show us that you lift someone from the grave? Because we heard that Isa Islam was able to do that. And that Sahabi of Isa Islam, he said, I know that I'm not capable of doing this, but he said, Ya Rabbi, that you, to show these people your power and to make them to come to the right way, then he asked for that help. And then he said to the grave for the person to rise up. And that person rose up from the dead from the grave. And as soon as he woke up, he said, where's my donkey, where's my donkey? And he said that the reason he did that is that his whole life, while he was alive, he was worrying about his animal and he was worrying about his donkey. So when he rose from the grave, that was the thing that he was concerned with, that same dog.
He was worrying about his donkey all the time. And he died. His time came up, he died. He will get up in the judgment day. Whatever, you know what Prophet is saying? Whatever you are busy with, that's how you will die. The way you will die, that's how you will be buried. way you will be buried, that's how you will rise to the judgment day. And that one was busy with his donkey all the time. He loves his donkey. Always with donkey. As soon as he got up from the grave, that time was he's gonna get up for judgment place. Looking at where's my donkey? Where's look what you are busy with. What is your heart is busy with? What is your body is busy with? It's not too much problem. What your heart is busy with? If your heart is busy with Allah, you're okay. Your hands running in dunya is too no problem. Once upon a time, the Sheikh took his murids. They went to a Hajj. And they have seen a man in front of Kaaba praying so good. He lost himself. And the Muris became so amazed with that one, looking and saying, oh, our chef, we wish to be like this one. Saying to them, wait, us to rush. Let me check his heart to see what he is doing there. He said, outside forum is showing that he is busy with Allah, but let's see. He closed his eyes, he checked his heart. Said he's no good for nothing. That his body is front of the Kaaba, but his heart busy with dunya. He is the lover of dunya. So don't go near to that one, saying, because that sickness will pass to you. He will make you to think that he is so good in the way of Allah, but that only thing is going to come to you, that sickness from that one, what is in his heart. Time passed, they came to Medina, Prophet's Masjid, and there is this young man, he's so happy, he's selling things, joking around with his customers, next to the tomb of the Prophet, ﷺ. And he's very happy, he's showing happiness to others, he's making everybody happy, and he's selling things. The murids, they say, oh, this one, how heedless he is. He is in the city of the Prophet. He is enjoying that he's selling dunya and he's happy. He's so happy because he's earning so much money. Everyone is waiting to buy things from him. Says, say, don't rush, wait, let me see. He closes, he looks at his heart. He says, he's okay. He said, his heart is busy with the Prophet. His hand is busy with dunya. That's the way it's supposed to be, he said. Says that happiness that it is in his heart is reflecting to his body, to his work, and everything else around. Says that's where all those customers, they running over there, says, they don't really want anything. But he's like a glue, he's pulling them. That's the bottom point. You like it or not? You don't become like that. The prayers become disaster to you. You cannot get up in the morning. You cannot do things. It just, it's like a torture to you. So wake up. Some of your heart, that kind of fatiha.